Hello guys, welcome back. After a real long pause, we are finally back with the Draft League. Another one from Neo. This season's going to be Radical Red themed. I don't know. Yeah, doesn't show it here. But Season 9, Radical Red. We missed Season 8 because it got cancelled. We missed 8.5 due to an unfortunate event. But now we're back. First season after everything, and I got this fabulous team right here. Yeah, no icons are going to show, but the person we're fighting week one is going to be Zunkin, aka, oh wait, not Zunkin, I don't even think Zunkin's on here. It's Zap, Albuquerque Ampharos, and his very high point team. With a bare minimum amount of mons. Now let's go ahead and get to prepping and see what we can't work out with this team here. Drag this over here. This is the client that we're using if anyone wants to try and join on and mess around with stuff. And it's not made by us, but it's there, it exists. Delete these because I was just viewing mons. Leave the format Radical Red Draft. Let me verify. Should have done this beforehand, but didn't. All games must be played in the draft format. There's like four. Assuming this one. Alright, so. Instantly, I kind of viewed this team off, but I never made anything with it. They have four ice weak wands. We have no ice types, unfortunately. And then they got three electric weaknesses. One immunity and one quad resist. And their only immunity is Crocodile. Which Helios can't really take on. Hidden power is allowed. Hidden power is allowed. I do think I want to bring my Mega, just for the meta. For Metagross, Skull of Heed. And yes, they do have Stealth Rocks, but my Mega is immune to those. Thanks to Mountaineer. Which, can't have that. Let's fix this. Otherwise, I'm going to just get a forfeit loss and instantly lose. Types. They only have one weakness to rock. Two weaknesses to fire. Three resist. I do have a very slow team, so they will likely take the speed advantage from me here. So I may just focus on being bulky. So I think I want Fire Lash to lower the defense of whatever I hit. That way nothing could just come in and sit in on me for free. We want Leech Seed. Leech Life for recovery. They have two weak, four resists. But their only resist is Metagross. Metagross is neutral. Their quad resistance to Lucha. Their normal resistance to Token Kiss. Scolipede's a quad, I believe, or just a normal. Yeah, at least you, at least life's fine. Power Whip's still 90 accuracy, but we're still gonna take it. Just in case Rotom Wash tries to switch in on me. And then we don't get no healing. I could go Coil for setup. Make Power Whip 100% accuracy with just one click. However, that would also mean that I would have to be kind of fast. Because otherwise I'm just going to sit there and get hit. I think Knockoff's kind of better. Don't want the physical sweeper. Yes, I have items and stuff, but I mean, I have all damaging moves, but I believe Senna Scorch kinda. Not G-Max. I get bulkier, and I still hit super hard. And with Fire Lash dropping defense as I hit, we're gonna get by pretty quickly. So this should work out. And like I said, I might make some changes off camera, like I've done in previous seasons, where I change up some EVs just to make them a little more specific for stuff, but if I do, I will cover that before the match actually starts. They have no terrain set up. Nothing that's gonna set up terrain to give Hawlucha its item perk for Unburden. So I kind of wanted to bring hazards, that way I can go ahead and get those up. Ensure they can't run Focus Sash and get away with it. I think my only hazard setter is going to be Bronzong though. Oh, Gastrodon gets Stealth Rocks. And Gastrodon would be nice for the Rotom because it basically perfectly counters it. I could probably Scald Stall Metagross out. I'm immune to anything but Barrel Thrones at me that's water type. I have a decent answer for Crocodile. Not perfect, but. And paired with Cyndasquorch, it can handle the Appleton. I am using a prep sheet off to the side, but it's not exactly perfect because it doesn't have none of the Radical Red additions. So I think I want Scald for burns, Recover to actually heal. Stealth Rocks would be nice. Okay, so apparently they don't get it. So either the stock's wrong, or it's an addition that they gave to Amon on their server. Still gonna bring Gastrodon though, I think it's still a fit. Ice Beam's nice for coverage. Debating if I want Earth Power for Stab, which doesn't really hit anything on this team besides Metagross, if I deem Metagross that big of a problem. Or do I want Clear Smog to try and reset Spectrier's boost with Grimnay, Crocodile's boost with Moxie? Actually, I'm not outspeeding Crocodile, and I'm probably dying to Crocodile and Spectrier anyways. This really only stops the Lucian if I catch it super early.
I don't think I want that. I think I want this calm.
So I got a decent physical Pokemon here that has great offensive potential. They have zero fire moves. Well, they probably have some fire moves, but no fire types, period. So I could run, because this is basically useless, unless the Rotom throws out a Will-O-Wisp. Which if it does that anyways, I'm probably going to be mega'd already. And I'm probably not staying in on a Rotom. And switching into this is a risk. I'd rather switch into Gastrodon on that. Flame Body would be nice to try and burn Crocodile, maybe, if I'm not Mega yet. But I see no reason not to just Mega Evolve in front of Crook. If it's super early and I don't Mega, I think I'd... They don't have Sticky Webs or nothing. No Intimidate Mons besides Crocodile. And if I'm Mega, I'm already losing out on that anyways. I mean, White Smoke's nice, but if they switch, this would give me the immunity first, then I'd be able to Mega after. I think White Smoke's better, just in case Intimidate Shenanigans try to happen. Got my Fire type, got my Water type. I think we'll be putting Bronze on here. Levitate's nice, so it does give me a ground immunity, so Crocodile can't just come in and spam Earthquake and get away with it. Let's think. Psyshield Bash is interesting. I don't think I'm really going to be clicking that a lot. It does have higher attack though. And they're only Dark types Crocodile. They do have a Ghost type, so I can't just run screens with Body Press. Crocodile does have knockoff. I'm like 90% sure of that, so. Could do Cobra Berry Body Press just for the Crocodile, and with Levitate it can't hit me. And just for the Crocodile. That's kind of hyper specific. And then if I have Body Press, Stab Gyro Ball maybe? Then what would my other moves? Oh, Stealth Rock. Screens would be nice, however, I think I'm gonna try and risk this. Gyro Ball, Body Press, that covers a good little bit. They only have one Steel Weak mon and it's Togekiss, and I completely block that thing. Spectre is super fast, so it's gonna take damage from it, definitely, and it's frail. Crocodile doesn't want to take a Body Press too much, does it? Is This is radical red, not insurgent, so I think this is fine. Bombs on. Purple dial. Body press. Take this away, put that there. Make you impish. Actually not impish. What would it be? Plus defense, minus speed, relaxed, I think. Yeah. Relaxed. It takes one. Doesn't want to, but it can take one. Which I guess, let's just go ahead and get that hooked up anyways. Relaxed. That's my physical bulk, that's my special bulk, this is my mega offense. The gyro ball is nice, actually. Okay, yeah, already took the speed away. Throw Slice Shield Bash. I guess it helps with Hawlucha a little bit, and Scolipede, because it gives me stab to take on Scolipede with. Which Scolipede's probably going to be speed boost. Alright, I'm neutral on bug. I'm immune to poison. Speed boost. Gyro Ball kind of just handles it. Gyro Ball, Psy, Shield, Dash. Scolipede. Maybe it's the suicide lead? They're doing the exact same damage. Unless it starts getting speed boost, they're doing the same, and Gyro Ball is going to outpace Slice Shield Bash anyways. So actually, I think I'm going to put Earthquake here for that Metagross. Because that lets me hit Metagross pretty somewhat reliably, and I don't think Metagross has anything to hit me back with. Body press, which it could probably use to get away with. It's not clicking a still move, not clicking a second. It also has Slice Shield Dash now. I doubt they're running Shadow Ball on here. They could possibly run like Gravity Earthquake, but I don't see them doing that. And unless they're Magnet Rise, I will be able to still hit them. They really shouldn't be able to do that much to me. Metagross. Cosmic Power? Oh, Body Press right there. That's what I was looking for. Ain't touching me. I can't do nothing back, but it can't do nothing to me either. This also isn't with any speed. They might run speed. But the only thing they're going to really try out speed. Maybe Heracross? No, Florges. They might try out speed. No, I don't have Florges. I have Eternal Floette, which is faster than that. It's just on the document, so I can't really use that. Yeah, no, they really have nothing that's trying out speed me with Metagross. They might just run full bolt. And also, this isn't max defense IVs either. Oh, and I have Slice Shield Bash, not Earthquake, which I would probably be clicking anyways. I will slowly win that battle. Possible 6 hit, possible 5 hit. So yeah, I should be able to win that. I got 4. Then we'll throw stealth rocks on there. That should help me out there. And since I am kind of trying to go up against Crocodile, it might actually be worth it to put the Culverberry on here. I don't got a Vinegar, so let's get rid of that. Now there is something I would like to mess with that I did draft. The Fast and Frail Illusions Orc, which gets a power boost, which is basically life orb when it's hidden. And since I'm already gonna have a life orb anyways, might as well put Scarf on here. Freeze powers. Yeah, but they changed freeze. Now it's that frostbite stuff, which just has special attack. It's basically just worse scald at that point. Because it's weaker too. However, their fire answers are kind of low, so maybe flamethrower. Which I guess hits Scolipede. That's really all it hits is Scolipede, because Appleton's neutral, and with Thick Fat it resists. I don't know about that. I know I want Shadow Ball. Put that on there, that's fun. Hyper Voice, just good neutral. Only one resist, I believe. One resist, one immunity. So only Metagross and Spectre are stopped at, and they both don't want to switch in on this Shadow Ball. Poltergeist is interesting. We do want U-turn. Let's switch out occasionally. Kind of think of focus blast more than flamethrower. I already got a fire type. Got no fighting coverage. They got 2 months weak to fighting. It's Crocodile and Barrel Eye. Maybe not a barrel, but Crook would definitely be nice to be able to smack. Do I have to risk the Focus Miss, or can Low Kick handle the job? Hasty, that way we don't nerf ourselves. Move that for right now. Grass Knot almost kills. What does Focus Blast do? Focus Blast outright kills. Unless they're bulky. And how does Low Kick fare? Probably the same. But weaker, because I'm hasty and all that. Let's run Utimitan. And let's put the Focus Blast on there. Now, I do think I should probably bring something that can heal. I feel like Rotom's gonna be throwing out status with like Will-O-Wisp a lot. Appleton's Mega gets Contrary, I know that. But here... I believe they're just Team 12. Everything seems to have its normal ability, besides Appleton, which is Contrary. Everything else is standard, okay. Knowing this, I already got a scarf on, so I don't think I need a second one. Does Floa Eternal get recovery? Can you wish pass? You could wish pass. And you're kind of fast, too. Protect. Run Moonblast over Light of Ruin because I don't want to kill myself off. Get walled if Metagross does come out on this one, which I really don't want to stay in anyways, so. I don't want to run Hidden Power Ground, because Rotom exists, and that has Levitate. They got two flying types already. Plus a ground resistant Appleton. So running that wouldn't be beneficial. What's something Metagross itself is weak to? That he doesn't have many options to cover for. Ghost is kind of revealing. Fire, he has a couple answers for. Really only it. Dark, I guess, but eh. Dark hits the same thing as Ghost, and if that's the point, I might as well just... Actually, Dark's safer because it lets me hit Spectre as well. Natural Cure, so they can't Toxic Stall me. They got a real offensive team though, so I don't think they care about that. Okay, well, how do I set the... But let me fucking... Actually, I don't see why I gotta do all that. Dark, IVs, Hidden Power. No, it says Hidden Power Dark would be 31 across the board except for attack. I thought about the Hidden Power Dark thing. else says 31 across the board would give you hidden power dart. All I needed was max tech. Okay. I don't think no one's gonna click foul play on me. Now I need one more mon. I already got my ghost immunity ready to go for that damn spectre over there. And my normal immunity for the bibarel. Got double water immunity for Rotom and bibarel. I got a grind immunity and bronze on. Got a fighting immunity for that Hawlucha and Zoroark. I got a dragon immunity and Floette for the Appleton. So it can't get away with that. If they use the new move that Radical Red added, they let you hit a fairy type for neutral, they will lose the match because that was banned, Draco Barrage. I don't want to say bulky Honchkrow would kind of get away with this. Honchkrow might. It's already faster than Crocodile. Barely, but it is. And by proxy, it's faster than Togekiss, Rotom Wash, Metagross, Bibarel, Appleton. It lets me click Brave Bird on Appleton, Brave Bird on Hawlucha. I believe you get a fighting move. Do you get superpower? Yes, you do. Superpower on Crocodile. Any dark move on Spectre. Brave Bird? You get Brave Bird, right? Yeah. Brave Bird on Scaldipede. Rotom Wash kinda gets away for free. Metagross instantly takes a dark move, and Bibarel takes a super power. And your speed got buffed to 96, so I might do so. You get any move to boost your speed? Get Tailwind. This would also give me some kind of clear away, just in case they get hazards up before I get the Sun Scorch into Megad. There's no flying. Oh, I know. Drill Peck has a high crit ratio. Okay, so Drill Peck, Night Slash. I think we might take Pursuit. I know I want Superpower. This kind of leaves me open to the Rotom, but it kind of handles everything else as well, besides Togekiss. And I have nothing for either of Togekiss nor Rotom. This is banned. I think I'll just grab Pursuit. If I could get in on Spectrier or Metagross and scare them out and click Pursuit, they go down. Maybe not Metagross, but Spectrier 100% fucking does. Scope Lens, Super Luck, Drill Peck, Night Slash. These two won't get no boost, but... Oh wait, no, then I lose out on Hazard Removal. Which my team isn't really that weak to hazards anyways. Like, if I go pull up my types, Rock, I have one mon weak and a two resist. Spikes do flat damage. Bronzong's immune, Honchkrow's immune. Everyone else kind of takes it, but Cinderscorch is kind of bulky. He might get away. Floette can heal. And Floette's fat. Well, now you're not fast. You were fast. You would be fast, but now you're not. Zoroark's definitely fast. Zoroark's killing something. Toxic spikes might be annoying, but... And actually, between Cinderscorch stopping Metagross's steel moves, Bronzong just blocking Metagross entirely, Gastrodon taking the steel moves, Honchkrow being immune to the psychic moves and ground moves, I think that opens up Floette here to then run Aromatherapy just in case they do get Toxic Spikes up. I have an option around it. Or I get rid of Pursuit and I put Defog in it. Now they got three mons that can set up Stealth Rocks, Metagross, Crypt, Albuquerque. But their only one that can set up Spikes and Toxic Spikes is Scaldabaoth. I think Stealth Rocks are likely to go up. And they will be annoying, but manageable. I don't think Spikes and Toxic Spikes are gonna come up. Especially since my team so heavily scares Scaldabaoth out with Cinderscorch just basically being able to kill it. Dragalge sitting in front of it pretty freely. Bronzong walling it. Hisuian's work might be able to outspeed and kill it. And Honchkrow wants to kill it too. But they still might bring it. Just for a revenge killer, maybe. I think I definitely leave, like... Well, actually, if I'm scarfed... No, because I don't have Flamethrower. But if I replace this with Flamethrower, I can't kill the Crocodile. Unless I go to Bronze on click Body Press, and I gotta do this on a ground-type move. Friend. What if I do this? Now Floette's fast and offensive, and I go from healing 176 to 144. I lose 30 healing points, but it should be fine. Then we'll run speed. Put Timid on here. I outspeed the Crocodile now too. Fuck that Crocodile. It's getting kicked in the teeth, and I got Fast Wish now. I think this is gonna be the final team here. Cinderswitch with Omega, Gastrodon, especially defensive with Scald to lower the physical attack, help that out, help Bronzong and Honchkrow out. Recover Ice Beam Earth Power for stab and coverage. Bronzong. Bulky's here to sub Stealth Rocks and take on Krug, possibly. Zoroark's the Revenge Killer with Illusion Boost. Which I might... Who would I disguise Zoroark as? Like, just at the start. Because at towards the middle of the game, I'm not going to be able to control that, really. I would say it's Bronzong, but Bronzong's gonna attract a dark move. Which could bait in the Crocodile, and then I focus blast it, and I kill it. But it also could just bite me in the ass. Well, that would attract a poison or steel move, which could bring in the Metagross as well. But it also could possibly bring in, you know, probably be Metagross every single time. Gastrodon would bring in Appleton pretty freely. Sinistrum would likely bring in Togekiss or Hawlucha. Hoshkrow? Who the hell would Hoshkrow bring out? Probably Rotom more than likely. And I could just U-turn out on that. Hoshkrow gets U-turn, so it would be somewhat believable. Yeah, you get U-turn. Probably the only one on this team that I could click U-turn on. And it still looks somewhat believable. You're set up for crits. Your support, which technically I could switch you out for Eldegoss, but Eldegoss doesn't get a wish. But Eldegoss would complete the Fire, Water, Grass core. But really, I already have an answer for Metagross. I got a couple for him. I got the perfect counter to Rotom and Gastrodon. Crocodile kind of goes a little unchecked, but Rotom kind of helps with that, and so does Honchkrow. Togekiss, I kind of just do Bronzong for that one too. Hawlucha kind of gets handled by Zork pretty well. Maybe Honchkrow. Honchkrow does have decent HP, so it might be able to survive a hit. Actually, yeah, Honchkrow could bring out Hawlucha. Togekiss, Crocodile, Spectrier. I kinda just need Zork and Honchkrow alive if that thing comes out. Scolipede gets handled by Cinescorch, Bronzong. Honchkrow could kill it, but Honchkrow doesn't really want to come in on it and take the lock move, like Rock Slide. Rotom is Gastrodon, Metagross. Gastrodon, Bronzong, Cinescorch. Maybe Honchkrow as well in there. But if Metagross clicks a steel move, Honchkrow's dying. And bibarel. Between Gastrodon and Zora, I got that covered. This, I think, will be the final team. So let's title it Week 1 versus Zap. And I'll see y'all guys at the battle. Alright, hello guys, welcome back. Okay, we're about to fight Zap right now. Ignore this, but... Team, I made no changes to it. The team seems fine, as long as he doesn't bring certain mons together, which he might, it's a possibility, but... I think this team should work out fine for us. Just hope that it actually does. Because I also went back and looked at some mons. His Rotom Wash got move additions to it, so it has like surf and stuff now. I don't know if that's the correct format. The other people are playing different formats. He did bring the contrary Appleton, which is kind of annoying, but... I mean, it will lose Thick Pet, but I also had to predict that with the switching. Let's see. My best is probably on, but I have no removal.
apples on. I'm just gonna have to hope they lead with Sin Scorch. I mean, Scullipede. Maybe Appleton might be scared of Sin Scorch too. Togekiss doesn't care. Rotom Wash doesn't care. I don't know about Spectre. I don't think it cares. I think it just clicks move anyways. And then Crocodile, well, he'll just click Earthquake. I just click Shadow Ball here because if he clicks a Ghost, which he most likely will, he won't hit me. And I'm Scarf, so I should be faster. If he outspeeds here, that means he's Scarf. My best Dark Resist is Honchkrow or Floette. Floette ain't taking a move from Crocodile, so. Oh, so that shield, that hurt from that hill. I don't expect you to use Frail, but goddamn, Zoroark. Whatever he sends in has to pick up Life Orb, Shadow Ball, basically. His best bet's Crocodile, probably. Maybe Rotom can take it. Well, my Togekiss answers this. Sucker Puncher. What is Appleton trying to do here exactly? If he clicks Draco Barrage, he's instantly losing this. Earthquake he can't use. I resist Lisa. I resist Draco Meteor. He can body press me. That's neutral. Unless I'm doing a lot. Sucker Punch is probably his best bet, but I don't know if he's running that. I was so close to getting that kill. You don't kill. I have to. Zoroark.
Scorch is still fashionable, so. What has 349? I have 349. That's super effective. This is life orb boosted. I did 97. So, this should kill. Click Hyper Woods for safety. I got Scarf with Life Orb boost. Zora kinda gets away with this. Can't send in Togekiss or Skullkick because they take 70, but they take a quarter, and I can click Hyper Voice because I should be faster than both of them. Unless one of them is Scarfed. So I think Xenoscorch should kill here. I think he has to do Crocodile right now. And I am locked in the Hyper Voice. I don't know about no radical red damage calculator. It's fine. Oh, he did. Just click it, see what happens. Worry about that later. Montrose faster. Mega Sinistral should be faster as well. It is 48. No hidden power grass. Setting up screens. This was without the screens now take effect. I can still send its aura with a shield. It says Scorch is faster. No. If he's jolly, plus one he also easy. You're low, you die to Stealth Rocks, I'm not worried about you. I just need you weaker. You're low as well, and you're gonna take Stealth Rocks. And I still got Gastrodon for that Rotom. Montrose should be able to take on Crocodile, hopefully. But if he sends in Crocodile, I'm just gonna stay in. And I'll just click a move and figure out if I can just do something. Slow. Oh yeah, I can do my speed build. I'd still be slower anyways. Really regretting not throwing hidden power on. Look, buddy, you ain't special if you think you're the only one with recovery. I could sit here. Nah, he's switching right now. He's set up the light screen. You switch it. Click it again. Click it again, switch to crooked out, and let it take a plus one skull. I'll win this eventually. You've revealed your whole learns, so there's like an entire grass in there. That's fun, I got the burn. Actually, we'll just see if he's slow bulky too. He should still outspeed me though. Yeah. I live, can't get burned, and I miss a cold. Okay, punished. That's fun. Really hope that would have hit. Yeah, he's gonna win the stall war. I literally just can't do shit about that.
Just hope to crit through it.
Can't vault switch, she has to hard swap. I'm faster than crypto too, so if I do live, I can click superpower on him. I don't think Gastron takes a hit and Snow Switch slow. I'm assuming he's scarred. Doesn't matter how nothing else seemed to be. If he outspeeds me here, then I think I lose to Scarf Moxie. I don't know who that is. Oh, they turned 25. I never paid attention to that. Hopefully I do win this, but if I don't, it's still pretty close. It came down to like a 3v1. That Rotom was just a pain in the ass of stalling. Oh, come on, man. Wait, I was faster. He ain't scarfed. Oh, wait, I have nothing faster than him anyways. That changes nothing. Gastron dies here. I think the turn where I stayed in and attacked the Togekiss and took a hit, I think that's the part where I messed up. Because I should have switched to bronze on. It's not Life Orb, right? Not Life Orb. Was slower than Honchkrow, so it's not Scarf. Unless he's min speed scarf. I'm so lost. Why did he not knock off right there and kill me? I don't know if that was a misclick. That's the wrong time. Replays. Thank you for downloading the replays instead of sending that. Yeah, that one do nothing. Alright guys, well, we somehow won the first week due to a misclick. So I guess there's bad plays on both sides. But we got a week one win, so let's go. I'll see y'all guys next week.